who have the art of tasrih, the embroidery. So there's an illusion. And it's an old-style street activism on the calico, artists against apartheid. But here, we're moving to 21st century. And we have a site. We're going to blog, we're going to Twitter, we're going to Facebook. And the statement that Phil read out will be on there, and it will grow. It will grow exponentially because of how young people, a lot of whom are not here, who are active in Sydney, how they negotiate, how they communicate. Now, this is not just a beautiful logo that... This is not just a beautiful logo that's been designed by a company that we contracted. This is political, cultural work, discussion of how do we project ourselves, how do we own our own name and our own image. Okay, I'm going to try and speak quietly. I want to return to the beginning of yesterday. It seems like a long time ago. The opening was inspirational with Heather Woodall and Gossam Kaj. And I want to return to their words in a way of rounding up two very intense days. Heather really coherently introduced the conference by acknowledging the land of the Gadigal and the Wongal Wongal peoples that we're on. Now, people who are new to Australia might think that this is a protocol that we have to abide by, and maybe people who have been working for a long time think, okay, this is how we work. But in cultural, political, grassroots activism, when we're working with communities, if we want people to understand and listen to our story in Australia, if we want people to understand and listen to the story of Palestine, first, we have to hear it through the ears and the prism of the stories of the people on this land. And that is really essential for us in starting the model of artists against apartheid that intrinsically links the occupation and the apartheid system that continues on this land with Palestine that we've been focusing on and the Israeli apartheid system. And it's about listening and working with each other. Heather also acknowledged that today is the anniversary of Al-Nakba. And unfortunately, that word in Arabic, Al-Nakba, the catastrophe, has not been incorporated enough into mainstream discourse in Australia. Right. There are Arabic words that need to become normalised. Just as many other languages in this land become normalised, we are working in a context where our languages, our Arabic languages, are demonised. So people who work for Palestine, Al-Nakba is a word. It's about 48 and we return to Al-Nakba. And today is the anniversary and we appreciated how Charlotte this morning asked us to reflect and stand for a moment's silence. The third introduction that Heather welcomed us with was the notion of freedom of speech. And for any cultural or political activist who works around Palestine in this country knows how difficult it is to have freedom of speech. And those of us who are cultural activists know that so many institutions, great and small, especially in New South Wales, are very skilled at censoring Palestine. Mm. I want to move to what Gossam inspired us with. He talked about critical imagination. And I sit there thinking, how do we deepen that? It's not just a phrase that he's throwing at us. Critical imagination. He talked to us about the traditional political way of working that is the anti. And that's really old rhetoric of resistance. The anti, it's got its place. But with artists against apartheid, we hopefully will move to the other area that Gossam was talking about, the alter. To be able to imagine new possibilities. It's not only about new possibilities on this land that is highly contested and negotiated every day, but new possibilities for Palestine. And so, even like self-criticism is incredibly important. So when listening to Ghassan talk about the ante and the altar, I was sitting there thinking, does our artist against apartheid statement mix a balance of the ante and the altar? Now, such a thing is not new. Okay, artists against apartheid are international. There are chapters around the globe now, so we are finally formally joining that movement. But to my knowledge, traditionally the Arab artist union in the Arab world will not cross Israeli borders to work with or perform with or write with Palestinians. Even though their heart is there, they will not cross Israeli borders. So the concept, as many people have talked about boycott and sanctions, is not new. And on a personal level, so many people have always refused to buy Israeli products and engage with Israel as a state in terms of its institutions. Anyway, I'm supposed to be talking about cultural action, and I don't want to make any great statements. I want to raise questions like, what is cultural action? And I think it's relevant for every aspect of the discussion that we've had this weekend. And how do we redefine how our people work together? And it could be our people here in Australia, or it could be our people, Australia, Palestine, and internationally. In recent years, I've become very interested in the politics of listening. How do we work with people and listen on their terms, not our own terms? And there's so much that happens in my 30 years of experience of political activism where people don't listen to each other. There's a lot of rhetoric and banter in politically organised groups. So for some of us, we are constantly seeking, how do we speak and write and create in our own terms? And I think that's very important for a movement for Palestine or a movement against apartheid in Australia or in Palestine. How do we define things in our own terms, not only in response to the agendas that are set, not only in defence, not only in explanation? When we create art, whether it's a film or a book or poetry or music, how do we do it in our terms to break boundaries for ourselves? How do we challenge the way people listen, to change the way they listen? Okay, in this last plenary session, people are talking about how we're going to have a handle of all the networks that are working around BDH, let alone the broader human rights issues about Palestine. There are cultural activists all around the country. There are cultural activists in Western Sydney who are walking around Palestine all the time, but they are invisible to organised political groups quite often. There are young people who are making poetry, film, visual art about Palestine. And so let us not think that we are the only people. There's a real generational separation on some levels in terms of how people are activating. And so I just want to wrap up by raising that question. And I, no matter how many years I've worked, the questions are eternally important. We do not have a blueprint. And so the eternal questions about how do we create new visions, how do we create new languages for our work that can translate to reality on the ground. Now, I don't want to try and wrap up with any words anymore, because some of the people are going to come here and unfold listening to each other without words. So it's a perfectly symbolic way to wind up these 2 days. So we're about to have Adam and Muhammad Yusuf and Phil.